Guys, welcome back to Black Desert Mobile. New update review. Finally, the update is live, guys, and I'm gonna review all the patch notes. In this one, we have the Hadoom boss runs, we have new events, we have big changes to all classes. I'm gonna review all of them. It's quite a long list right there. So let's start first, guys, with the events, okay? So we have a continuation of Amazon Prime Collaboration Season 4. So let's see what we'll get. So, okay, Faded Enhancer Stone 3 and Chapra Dust 20,000, nice. Then next one, Reward, is it Reward 2? Reward 1, we already got it, okay? So we start from Reward 2. Reward 3, 300 Totem Chest. Reward 4, okay, 100k for Alchemy, Relic and Lightstone Fragments, that's nice. Reward 5, 5,000 Restoration Scrolls, and Reward 6, half a million Ancient Gold Coins and 5k Shaka to Exchange Certificate. Nice, that's nice. Oh wait, there is more. Sorry, there is more. Wow, okay, let's see. Round 7, 20,000 Boss Stamps and 20,000 Ancient Tablets. Wow. And Round 8, 30,000 Boss Stamps and 30. Wow, this is really nice. That's really nice, guys. Okay, so definitely I'm gonna get it. We still have Patricio, okay, World Boss Fragment Special Shop for another 40 days, 49 with today. We have new daily mission event, okay, so this will last these things for 2 weeks. I already reviewed this one. So keep in mind, you have to every day to do these 5, like defeat enemies in Hadoom, 3000, obtain dark coins. Very easy, 200, use experience scrolls, defeat 10 times, do 10 times, okay, boss rush, okay, doesn't matter if it's Hadoom or Alien version, and also craft, obtain holy vials, okay, of splendor, so one, pretty easy to do, but try to do every day these ones, and yeah, you get 2000 for 5 completion, boss stamps. Then you get 10 fragments, a 10, a 20, you get 60 holy vials, and 15 fragments to get the gear, okay, the pink gear with the fragments with the to craft it, very useful. At 50 you get another 25, so another 50 total fragments to exchange in here, okay, and you can get whatever you need, okay, which fragments you need, and 40,000 light stones. Okay, that's nice. Find, let's see, another one. Find the Black Spirit Lost painting for 1 week. And what we have to do, so there are 4 different paintings, and you have to collect one of each to get the reward. And they don't show in here. Okay, the reward I showed in my previous video. So, what you have to do for this one. You can obtain, there is through drops when you defeat monsters in Hadoom. So go to Hadoom and farm. There is a chance to get this one from Hadoom. The second one you can get from the defeating monsters in the Great Desert. Okay, so Hadoom, Great Desert farming. Also, a third one you can obtain from fishing. So guys, we need to go fishing, seriously. And fourth one, obtain when you reach floor 10 and floor 60 in Tower of Trials. So you should get 2. If you don't believe me, I already, gonna say I already have them in here. See, 2 of them. Complete and send again. I'm curious if I do multiple times, will I get more of those? We'll see. So how many times we can exchange? I think as many as of those rewards we can get. The hardest one, I think, I don't know, maybe this one. I already have 2 of this, see? So yeah, interesting. Let's see. Then we have Black Sun. Okay, so hot time, or not hot time, 3 times rewards, and you're gonna see there are some changes to the Black Sun. So with this one you get 3 times the rewards. Okay, whatever reward you get, you multiply by 3. So that's for 2 weeks, guys, 2 weeks time. Then we still have this one, and the World Boss Fragment Exchange event for another week. Okay, so these are the most important. Let's see. Okay, so Hadoom. Let's talk about Hadoom World Boss, guys. So Hadoom World Boss, in order to unlock, see right here, you have to clear Red Nose difficulty level 99 and also to complete Hadoom an easy piece. So those story, you'll see it in here. See, learn Hadoom. I already did the first two parts. The last one you have to defeat in Hadoom 1000 monsters, and I already did that. So let's claim. So with this I should be able to unlock, and you get Shadow Note, which you need to exchange, guys. That one you'll see, you'll need it to exchange for Hadoom bosses. So now I can switch, boom, to Hadoom. See, and you just, okay, you need 100 boss stamps and one knot. You see one of that. That you get it, that knot you can get from farming in Hadoom, guys. Also you can get from daily commissions. So, yeah, they are stronger than the normal version, you're gonna see. And actually, let's exchange. So 100 boss stamps and one knot. So let me exchange one time so you see what's all about. Boom, see? Now I have zero notes. And okay, so another thing you should know, in order to do the other bosses, I have to clear the first level for Hadoom Red Nose and also level 99 for Giant Alien version. Okay, same with the other ones. So one by one, that's how it works. Okay, so clear the Alien version level 99 and do the previous bosses. Just first level, you don't have to do level 99 for the Hadoom. And here, if we go, let's see the rewards that you can get, guys. You can get Eternal Helmet, which is the strongest gear in the game, but the rate is very low. You can get Primal Main Weapon, which is amazing, but the rate, I'm sure, is pretty low. You can get Glyphs. You can get Condensed Dark Energy, Lightstone Fragments, and Grand Weapon Blackstones. Keep in mind, the initial multiplier is 1, but the higher you go, you can get more. And if you activate Combat Plus, you have another plus 5 runs, okay, 1 plus 5. And for each level, guys, you get reward, okay? So after the defeat, see, the rewards are getting crazy. You start from 130 Grand Arbor Blackstones, then 28,000 Ancient Gold Coins, 416 statues, guys. That's a lot of silver. So if you unlock this one, if you need silver, guys, definitely try to clear for Red Nose at least a few of these levels, because you get lots of statues that you can sell for silver, and also the Grand Blackstones you can also convert into the ones that you can sell in the market, but they are quite cheap right now. Okay, so I'm gonna do a separate video and I'm gonna farm these bosses, but keep in mind also the experience and silver, even if it's more expensive, is 33.3% more expensive, because you need 100 boss stamps instead of 3, but the silver you get and the ancient gold coins is higher. I'm gonna do a separate video about this, okay? So just wait, guys. And by the way, when you exchange, there is a chance to get the special Hadoom bosses. I'm gonna do an exchange, but I need more knots, so I need to farm more in Hadoom. And after, guys, I'm gonna farm to see the drop rates for Hadoom. Okay, oops, let's continue farming here. And now, guys, very important, let's see the patch notes, okay? Because there are some, and also we're gonna check after the shop really fast, because there are some changes. So let's go to patch notes. Come on. Okay, it's sometimes it's loading very slow. So one second. Let's hope it will work this time. No. Come on, bro. Okay, let's read first the, let's check the what changes they have. Recommended offering for your CP. So now, depending on your CP, guys, you'll have in this shop recommended items that you can get with white pearls or money or black pearls. With black pearls it seems there is only one. And this one I can get 10 path of glory for 150, not 10, sorry, one path of glory extra entry for 150 black pearls. Not a good thing. Can you change these ones? Okay, so you can see them here. You can find them in there. Alchemy stones. I don't need alchemy stones, seriously. What's this? Lucky boss fragments pack. Okay, what will give this one? World boss fragments 50 to 100. Kind of expensive. And why no black pearls? Okay, there are more. Okay. But they are kind of expensive. Yeah, they should have added the pet alp. Oh, let's see pets. What? Ah, I know this pack. They're just showing you what packs are recommended to increase your CP, you know? Okay, let me see if there is something new. Hot, new. There are some new packs, as you can see. All that is with new, they are new. New ones. Seems no event shop is this one, okay. But no best deals. Nah, okay, so let's try again to get in the... Because I want to see, guys, all the changes to the classes. So one second, we're gonna review. Come on, just load. Finally. Okay, so here you can see the Hadoom boss rushes. Oh, by the way, you need to have to set Blessing of Light to tier 3 in order to enter. Holy Vials of Light will not be used when entering Hadoom, okay? So keep that in mind. There is a 3-minute limit time to defeat the bosses in Hadoom. So another thing that you should know. And changes, Black Sun schedule changes, okay? Will be Sunday and Wednesday only, so 2 days per week from 18 to 19. That's the first one, so 2 times per day. So on Sunday and Wednesday, 2 times per day. One will be from 18 to 19, and another one from 21 to 22 server time. Okay? The rewards will be separate. So you don't continue from, if you participate in both, from where you are left with the first participation of the day. So you start from the beginning, okay? Here you can see the time zone, okay. Okay, so let's see class balances. All classes will take reduced damage from other adventurers by 10% after using a melee skill. So that's a good thing because it's not fun to die that fast. So damage reduction by 10% after using a melee skill. So that means melee classes will get more of this buff. Okay, gladiator, you can see the classes, okay? And the skill they will use to activate that 10% reduction, okay? So these are the gladiator, berserker, huntress, and you can see the skills. So also range classes, but they need to use the melee, like wind, while Will of the Wind, Spin Blade. They need to use the close range skills. The melee skills, Windwalker, Titan, Destroyer, Archmage, Invoker, but for sure the close range will have more skills, as you can see, like Paladin, Titan, see, all the skills, they are close range, most of them, so they will have that buff more time available for them. So that's a good thing to balance the difference between melee and the range classes, okay? Also added a guild skill that reduce damage dealt from other adventurers when using a melee skill, okay? Can reach up to 5% depending on the skill level. So that's from the guild, another damage reduction. Major character balance change. They start first with Nova. So Coratum Charge is the first skill that got changed. Improved animation of running motion to connect more naturally using the skill. Charge is now sustained even if you don't hold down the skill button. charge will stop when another skill is used and you'll be able to use the other skill. That's okay. Winter Rat can be used more quickly if there aren't any targets to attack. Winter Rat, okay, reduce skill cooldown by 1 second from 7 to 6 seconds. Flow Northern Breeze effect will now already be applied, has now been changed to Flow Super Armor. Super Armor apply instead of Front Guard, okay, for that skill, Northern Breeze. Change the skill description to following since Flow. Northern Breeze will be applied by default. Changed from max 3 hits to max 5 hits for the same skill. So we're talking about the Winter Rat. Okay. Change effect from first hit to apply freeze and last hit to apply knockback effect to first hit will. Freezes. Second hit will apply knockback and last hit will apply knockdown effect. Okay, wow. Glacier Burst added flow assault skill so that you can choose whether to use the skill assault. Okay. Change to allow use of assault if the distance between you and the target widens while auto combat. Change to allow quick use of Winter Rat even when not hitting targets with assault. Assault skill increases the movement speed. Frenzy Bishop change to allow quick use of. Okay, so there are lots of changes as you can see, guys. You can read for each class. Let's overview all. Like, I cannot, it's the list is so long, guys. You can go and check for yourself. So, increase PvE damage for Blood Moon. This is for Lotus, okay? Increase PvE damage for Blood Moon, Chaos, Wind Slicer, Crescent Moon, and Flash Step. You can see right here the increases. For level 1, for Blood Moon, 308 to 420. There are for PV most of the changes, not for PvP. Wind Slicer, as you can see, the skill for 340 to 460, that's at level 1, okay? Crescent Moon from 350 to 450. Flash Step from 310 to 372. Added the effect knockback on last hit to the skill Chaos. Fix an issue where PvP damage did not apply normally on last hit when using the skill Chaos. Change retaliation skill effect from mana recovery to reduce crit chance. Adjust the number of targets you can hit to 5 when using the skill retaliation. Okay, so there are also some changes. Primrose, that's for the, this is the new class, Primrose. Increase PvP damage for Moonrise, Infinity Stab, Glacier Wall, and Midnight Require. So you can see the changes, 350 to 415 for Moonrise, Infinity Stab 285 to 315, Glacier Wall 460 to 505, 335 to 375 for Midnight Require. Huntress also got, so this got the these buffs, okay, the Primrose. Huntress, reduce the frequent use of kicks and basic attacks when playing on auto combat. Change to quickly use the skill after using the skill True Shot. Okay, adjusted the attack range of True Shot. Increase the PV damage of True Shot, Razor Wind, Flurry of Arrow, and Descended Current. You can see right here, True Shot for 560 to 780. Oh my gosh. Razor Wind for 355 to 425, Flurry of Arrows 422 to 480, and Descended Current 250 325. Also increased all attack range except for last hit. Wow. For the skill Will of the Wind. Okay, so for that skill. Oh, except for that skill, okay. Increases the attack range of skill for Piercing Arrow. Change to quickly find targets after using the skill Descending Current. Windwalker, increase the PV damage of Cyclone Fury, Vorpal Danger, Steel Tempest, Eternal Blast, and Rupture. Okay, so here you can see. You can go and check for yourself. Let's see what other class. Also increases the attack range and attack speed of Wind Slicer. Change to quickly use flow, additional attack using, guys, there are lots of changes also for this class. So it seems also the Windwalker got a buff, same like the Nova. So these classes, and we'll see the Titan also. Here you can see the changes in damage. Archmage, the only change, reduced maximum duration of invincibility when using the skill Frigid Fog. That's good, okay? Was too OP. So no buff for Archmage, I'm happy, because Archmage was too OP. Invoker, change skill effect of Lightning Stone from Days of Hit to Knockdown on Hit, okay? Increase Lightning Stone attack speed and how quickly it can be connected as a combo. Increase PV damage of Lightning Storm and Electric Wave. That's for the Invoker. Okay, so that's the other version of the Archmage. Okay, so there are also Static Shield from 3 seconds to 5 seconds. Cooldown. You can see right here. Spirit Walker. So Spirit Walker PV damage off. Breath Down, Dance of the Red Phoenix, Dance of the Blue Dragon, Dance of the Black Tortoise, and Dance of the White Tiger. Okay, so you can see here the changes. Adjust the cooldown of Dance of the White Tiger for 3 seconds to 5 seconds. Reaper also. Increase the attack range of that circus. Increase the PV damage of that circus. Soul River. Carcian, Rat, and Soul Spike. Oh my gosh. Okay, so here you can see the damage increase, PV mainly, and adjusted the cooldown of Soul Spike for from 12 to 10 seconds. Destroyer, let's see, Destroyer, okay, this is mine. Increase the PV damage of the To the Grave, Slugfest, Tectonic Rift, and Funeral Blast. So here are the increase. That's it for the wow. Only that's it. Destroyer. The Titan got more buffs. Void Knight, increased PV damage of Fury of Kalamacia, Legacy of Vedir, Dancing Blades, and Eclipse. Okay, that's for the Void Knight. Phantasm, increased the attack range of Vadiant Shockwave, change the Nova chain skill effect from Bound on Ground 1 first hit to Bound on Hit. Okay. Increase attack range of the last skill hit on Nova Chain. Increase the PV damage of Nova Chain and execute. So here you can see Nova Chain and the damage increases. Also fix the issue where the invisibility effect granted from the evasion skill lasted abnormally long. Okay, I didn't know that. Adjusted the knockback distance applied to monster when using certain skills. Increase the rear attack range of Vadiant Shockwave. Increase last attack distance and added bonus effect on Nova Chain. Blade Master increases the PV damage of Rising Storm, Serpentine, Squall, and Rest in Peace. Okay, Blade Master. Warlord increases the PV damage of Circus, Slash, Conduit, and Upper Hand. And also adjusted the mana cost to use the skill back draft for from 30 to 20. Mana points. Paladin increased the PV damage of Celestial Spear, Sword of Judgment, Sharp Light, Divine Wrath, and Judgment of Light. Here you can see the stats. Okay. Lancer increases the PV damage of Holy Trust, Divine Judgment, and Retribution. You can see here the increases. Grandmaster increased the PV damage and energy vacuum, Chip Shop, Gale Force, and Rising Uppercut. So as you can see, all classes got buffs for skills, but in PvE, some in PvP also. Like the okay, Gladiator increased the PV damage of Heavy Strike, Blaze Strike, Ground Smash, and Deep Thrust, and also increased the attack range of Deep Thrust. Okay, Titan, another class that got a bigger reward, changed the skill Smackdown to Pile Driver. Change the skill animation of Pile Driver to perform an additional attack upon using 60 mana points. Additional attack cannot be used if you fail to grab a target with the skill Pile Driver. The effect Enhance Reduce Cooldown is applied by default and it has been changed to the skill Flow Toss. Change to allow the use of Pile Drive, Fearsome Tyrant, Beastly Wind Slash while using Ranging Thunder. Okay. Enhance Increase range is applied by default and change the skill to flow thundering footsteps. Increase attack speed when flow thundering footsteps is not applied and increase movement speed when it is applied. Increase PV damage of flow and thundering footsteps. So here you can see the increased damage, thundering footsteps, and also in PV for flow instill fear. See, PV damage and PvP damage increased. Or no, it's not increased. For this one, it's increased. For Fearsome Tyrant. Okay, and also there are also added effects for more guard, not applying the arena. Added effects, super armor applied while using the skill, not applying the arena to the skill flow, additional attack for, okay. Increase the skill distance of Beastly Wind Slash, increase the duration of skill Lava Pierce, added the skill flow instill. So yeah, these are the changes for the Titan. Windwalker adjusts the skill effect of certain skills to make your character appear clearer. And Titan also fixed an issue when your character change to a falling animation after using Beastly Wind Slash from a high location. So these are, guys, the changes, lots of them. Let me know what you think, and yeah, see you in the next one. Bye, guys.